Good morning, mateys. Good morning, everybody. Happy Monday. Yes, Monday. Hello, hello, hello. Gonna drive that school boat. Gotta get them pirates to school. You better believe it. You better believe it. Alright. Alright, happy Monday. Good morning, Platy Pants. Good morning, Indigo Boy. Good morning, good morning. I have not been on Sea of Thieves for a while. I'm still trying to decide what I want to, what sort of next RPG type thing I want to play, because it's probably what I'm going to end up playing. So I'm going to waste a little more time, play some little more random things, see what people enjoy. Today we're just going to chill, we're just going to hang out on the high seas, and have a good time. There's some fishing event happening on here that I would like to investigate. But other than that, we're just hanging out. So how was y'all's weekends? Hope you had something interesting going on. Wasn't long enough, but it never is. Daylight savings kind of screwed up half of it, but you know, too short but good, yeah. It always is. Man, it's struggling to connect. What's happening here? I completely forgot that the time was changing. So my wife and I went to bed Saturday night, and we had played D&D Saturday evening. So we got to bed really late, and then as I'm laying down, I look at my phone. It's like, oh, it's almost 2 a.m. And then before I fall asleep, my phone lit up again. I'm making sure it was charging and stuff. So I leaned over and then it said 3. And I was like, I have not been awake that long. There's no way that it has taken, that I've laid here for that long in bed after this long a day. And there's no way. And then it all sort of started to line up. Oh, it is spring now. And I had a bit of an existential crisis at 3 a.m. Like, oh God, it's now almost morning, and I haven't gone to sleep yet, and now I have to deal with this tomorrow. Yesterday was a little hard. Oh, come on. What's happening, Sea of Thieves? Come on. What's going on? I hear, like, pages turning. It might have broken. It didn't say it's not responding. Setting sail. Ah, here we go. It just needed a second. Oh, boy. That music doesn't come up very well, does it? That's okay. Oh, okay. Thought it was going to break again. All right. So, the plan... Oh, that's old stuff. The plan that I have for today is to see if there's people around to torment. Figure out what... Oh, hey, look at that. Figure out what the fishing event is. And otherwise, chill out, have a good time, and figure out what we're doing the rest of this week. Actually, in that vein, I really want to play Mario Kart again. Is there a market for playing Mario Kart currently? Because I've been seeing more people doing that on Twitch. And I'm okay at Mario Kart. I'm pretty good at Mario Kart. I'm not gonna lie. The newest one, 8 Deluxe, I think, is what it is. Yeah, it's gotta be 8 Deluxe. The one on the Switch. I've been seeing some people playing it. Because I did figure out how to make it like a public lobby that everybody can get into on Mario Day last week. And that was cool. But I don't think anybody that was in the stream actually got on the stuff. It was just random people that found the tournament on the Switch that hopped in. But I would love to challenge just general people on Twitch to Mario Kart, because I want a challenge. I want somebody to rival me. I have played a good bit of Mario Kart 8. So like when on Mario Day, I did Mario Maker in the morning, and then that evening I did a little bit more Mario Maker and then Mario Kart. There was only one person out of about probably 25 to 30 people that actually came in and joined the tournament. There was only one person that actually had a consistent number of victories over me. So I want to find somebody to rival me. I want to find somebody that'll show me some excitement in Mario Kart. I want somebody to fight with. Didn't get in on that Mario Kart stream. Halfway decent myself. Awesome. But we'll do it again. I'll do it again this week sometime. I would love to. I want something that people on the stream can join in on anyway. And Mario Kart's really fun for me. And it's just like the perfect storm, you know? I've got friends that like to play it. People like to play it in general in the world, as far as I know. And it's an easy thing that everybody can get in on. And random people can get in on. Can't really join since I'm working half time. You're streaming. Ah, dang. I also do it later in the evening, too. One of them evening streams that I don't schedule. That I just randomly decide to do. Maybe I'll figure out some time. I will schedule something, maybe. I'll set up a big Mario Kart tournament and stream playing it. Maybe I could actually set up a whole rule set for a genuine tournament, maybe. Actually limit the amount of races and time to play and genuinely have a competition, not just play and see who wins for an indeterminate amount of time. Bet I can figure something out. Mario Kart's just fun. I just have a good time. Or, actually, I think I'm off this Friday. I think I'm off from my real job this Friday and could go for longer on Friday. Just do a bunch of Mario Kart. Ooh. That's skeletons? Yes, it is. Alright. Let's get out of here. Sunken Grove is this one over here. It should be. Yep, there we go. Alright. Let's hit the water. I'm going that way. Great. Awesome. Mario Kart's fun. Smash Brothers would be fun. I'm not incredible at Smash Brothers, but I enjoy it a lot. And I need to play more of Pyra and Mythra anyway. Maybe Smash Brothers could be fun. And then hopefully we can set up... I need to do some genuine preparation. This weekend was a little busy, so I didn't get what I wanted made for it. But I want to recreate Galactic Conquest from the original Star Wars Battlefront 2. At least as a graphic that I can put up on stream. And then me and a buddy are going to play Galactic Conquest on the new Battlefront 2 using a made-up map. And have some fun with that. Sort of like Risk, but using another game instead of dice. And that will hopefully go as well as I want it to. Otherwise, I've got a couple of random games that I'm trying to go through. I've got a massive amount of free stuff that came from Epic Games that I'm digging through. I'm trying to decide what I want to play next for more of a longer form series. I'm not feeling any real inspiration. I've got stuff on my Switch too that I could try to play. I don't know. I'm not sure. Can't decide if I want to try to break the mold, because I've done two solid RPGs. I've played Oblivion and Fallout. And while I really enjoy those games, there's a lot of other stuff that I almost enjoy more. Oh, I could play Breath of the Wild again. It's been a while since I've played that. And that's about that same kind of... I could do Master Mode on Breath of the Wild. Because I played a little bit of it, but I never beat Master Mode. Maybe that would be fun. I wouldn't mind replaying that anyway. I see you play Fallout 3. That is on my list. I personally would rather not go from one Fallout immediately into another one. Because that was the reason I didn't beat New Vegas back in the day. Was because I had just played 3 and then went immediately and tried to play New Vegas, and it just didn't... I just got burnt out. So I want to try to find something else to play first. And then Fallout 3 is on my list that will get played on this channel at some point in the future. As well as probably Skyrim. Skyrim would be heavily modded, but Fallout 3 will get played at some point. And then yesterday we were talking about stuff like Dragon Age and, Dragon Age and Mass Effect and all those games. And those... I could probably play one of those. Find the Grave of the Lonely Island of the West. Oops, that's a bucket. Lonely Island, yeah. This one. Oh, there's a skull there, too. Money. Right. Lonely Island of the West. The Grave on the Lonely Island, 6 paces east by southeast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You ever played Dragon's Dogma? I have not. I know the name. I recognize the name. If it's a solid sort of... fantasy RPG, I will add it to stuff to research. The problem with a lot of this stuff is I don't own these games, and I have bills to pay. And we're still sort of coming off the... kind of at the tail end of this quarantine that I wasn't able to work a whole lot, so that's a little bit of an issue. But, you know. By far one of my favorite older RPGs. The DLC is also very challenging. That's always cool. I do appreciate games that give you a little bit of an extra... Like, you beat it, but now we're going to give you an extra little bit of a challenge to really show your stuff. I do appreciate that. That's most of what I liked about Lonesome Road in New Vegas. maybe not most, but that was absolutely a portion of what I enjoyed. Oh. I've got, like I said, I've got a bunch of stuff on Epic as well that's been just free. Darksiders were fun. At least the second one was. I remember not being super impressed with the first one. But the second one was fun, and I never beat it either. Let's see, if I wasn't so poor, drop a fuck ton of bits on here so you could get all the games. That wasn't to be like, you guys should give me money so that I can go buy games. That was just, I'm gonna have to be a little slow about it, and I have to be a little responsible about this. I gotta keep the lights on. Type stuff. That wasn't a fishing for anything. I do get having limited gaming budget, but quarantine was quite rough. At the beginning of it, my job was nice enough that they were like, we have some extra, we can pay you a little bit. So I got paid a little bit for even though I wasn't working, I got paid as if I was working for a while there. But, you know, I didn't expect them to do that the whole way. And then it was a bit of a bitch to try and get the actual, stimulus checks. I did finally get them, but it was a bit of a process. Where the counter says one, there's definitely two of us. Yeah, Twitch is a little weird. I don't know what its problem is. There's always more people than at least one or two more than what it's actually showing. It's not it's probably only noticeable for this size of a stream. You know, you get into the bigger ones, it's like, oh, a three-person fluctuation is kind of whatever when they've got 100 people in there, but just now getting my stimulus on my tax refund. I had to wait for my tax refund. Get your stimmy faster with direct deposit on. I filed my taxes last year. I did it with direct deposit. It's the only way I've ever done it. I don't think I've ever had a mailed check to me. And, they just never sent it. Every time I tried to check on it, it was like, your status of your stuff is unavailable. Because there was somewhere on the IRS you could go check the status of your stimulus check, and it was like, it's unavailable, we can't tell you anything about it. I finally got it on the tax refund. I did them as early as possible, just so that I could make sure I got it, because it was starting to get necessary, just about. I'm usually pretty responsible with money and can save it well enough to sort of prepare for those sort of emergencies. But, it got a little close after a year of not being able to work as consistently as I should. Apparently they also do stimulus checks in the form of prepaid cards for some people. I don't know how I would feel about that. Because that would make it... Well, I guess you could still pay... Because all of my bills and stuff come out online. I don't go anywhere and pay bills. It all just does it usually automatically from whatever website. So I guess you could probably put in a card like that onto some of those things. It just feels like that would be so unsafe. I feel like that would cause some issues, or has the potential to cause issues, if you tried to punch in the numbers on a prepaid debit card onto like the electric company's website. It just seems a little risky. People have been mistaking them for junk and throwing them out. Oh god. Oh, that would kill me inside. Ooh. My heart would drop. I would. Ooh. If there was even the possibility of that. I check random junk mail just to make sure people aren't giving me free money. That's how paranoid I am about that sort of stuff. I'll get something from Geico that feels like it has a card in it, and it's usually just like a fake credit card that you're like, you're pre-approved for whatever thing, and I'll open it and dig through it and just make sure that it's not a real card. just in the off chance that there's a couple bucks in there. That's what this quarantine has driven us to. Me too. And to be fair, I did that before the quarantine, so never mind. I've just never really been that well off that I've always been like, you know what, if I can get a couple more bucks, I'll take a couple more bucks. I wasn't poor by any means, but we made do. I've never gone hungry or nothing. It wasn't that bad. But still, I check mail just in case there's money there. Just in case. Oh, I should get my bird out. Kazooie. Hello. You sit here? No. Here. Let me take you up here. Well, that snake's gonna burn. Sit. There. I'm gonna burn this snake. Okay. Nope. We're good. Is that really all I got from here? What is this one for? Shiver Retreat? I could go fight that guy. Oh, what else was going on this weekend? D&D was fun. Oh, God. I could tell some D&D stories. Yeah, we had a pretty interesting session Saturday. Without going into incredible detail and sparing you an entire 2 years of games worth of backstory, one of my players is cursed by the big bad evil guy, who is, he's currently sealed away in, like, spirit realm type stuff, right? Very, very Legend of Zelda. One of my players is cursed because she entered his realm to communicate with him for a short time a ways back. Well, she's had an artifact on and equipped to protect her from his intrusion into her brain. But it had been a while since she'd had any nightmares or communication with this connection of him. So at the end of last session, she removes the sacred ring that's protecting her from his influence with the intention of trying to communicate with him again. She is playing a druid who is a little under thrilled with how her class has sort of ended up. She has been wanting to change her subclass, which I allow. I have told her is allowed. It will just require a quest and some work. And she's trying to do some slightly rule-breaking things with her wild shape stuff, where druids can turn into animals and just get basically free health. She's a dragonborn, and she's trying to give herself draconic wings using her wild shape. As a wild shape thing, like be able to sprout wings and then fly and still do her normal actions and use her normal weapons and stuff and not have to be an actual lizard creature. So when she goes to communicate with this, with the big bad evil guy, he was like on the cusp of divinity before he was sealed away. He was almost immortal, almost a god. So now, she wants some of the stuff from Sorcerer. I think she just wanted to be a little more powerful as a druid. So one of the other subclasses that would have been more combat focused, I think. Either way, she didn't take the subclass change. What she did was went and talked to him. The big bad evil guy was absolutely all, I can give you everything you want, anything that your heart desires. My power can give it to you. All I ask for is to see. Previously, he had asked for control. Very vague, he wants to see and he wants control. And I reminded her of that. Out of character, I was like, this time he asked to see, and previously he has asked for control. She was like, "What? Your power is bad. I don't want your power." And then I pulled the whole, "Yes, but beyond your plane of existence, power is the same. The gods, my power." celestial power, it's all one and the same. It's what the user does that determines its characteristics. So she took it. She made a deal with the most powerful evil force that this party knows about for wings, for the power of permanent flight. So I went on for like 5 minutes describing this gruesome scene of her bones shifting and growing and sprouting out her back, her skin and scales ripping open at her shoulder blades, and then bones protruding and spreading out over her back, all while she's in this dream state. Like, she's not even awake for this. So she's in this dream, her body racked with pain, and she sees, like, skeletal wings sprout out from behind her, and then her skin begins to grow and stretch from the rest of her body out around these things. An incredibly painstaking process that was very fun to describe, that went on for about 5 minutes, and then she was left her normal draconic dragonborn body, now with wings that seem permanent, left alone in pitch black darkness in a vaguely dreamlike state. And she didn't wake up. She didn't come back out of the dream like she had previously. I ended the session. We stopped playing with, and you sat there alone in darkness with your new wings sort of huddled around you for much longer than your dreams usually last. And the dreamlike feeling is beginning to fade, and you sit here in pitch black darkness. And that's where I ended the session. And it was so cool. So now the entire table's freaking out, like, what did you do? Why are you doing this? You're a bit of a sadist. No. This was magic from the bad guy. This was magic from the one person that they are supposed to know to not trust. And she went for it. She wanted wings so badly that she was willing to get it from the big bad evil guy that wants to consume the world. This is not my fault. I'm not a sadist, I'm just very imaginative. I figured it was gonna have to be a little bit of a trade-off, so I had to describe it like it was a terrible thing. But she got what she wanted. It just came at a price, is what I was going for. It was exactly what she wanted, but she didn't ask questions. She wasn't trying to, explore all of her options here. She went to the big bad evil guy that she knows is very powerful and asked for something. And, you know, he granted that request. I even gave her, so he asked to see and for control, right? So in her dream, I asked her to make a wisdom saving throw as she felt darkness creeping into her mind where he was collecting on his end of the bargain, right? And I gave her the option to, I was like, you can make a wisdom saving throw or you can just let this happen. And she thought about it for a long time. Like, she did just ask for it, and then sat and debated for a good couple of minutes of whether she was ready to just allow him to do whatever it was he was gonna do, or try to fight it. I'm gonna die! I'm talking about D&D and not winning my fight. You blinded somebody to make them a pigeon? No. I don't think she watches this, so I will tell you guys. She's not blind. She's still asleep. She's not going to wake up for a few days. And the big bad evil guy is going to have control of her character. She gave up control of her character. He gets to see the world from her eyes. She's going to be missing for a few days. Maybe not missing. The party might be able to find her. I don't know how exactly I'm going to do that yet. No, she can very much see, and she will be back. She has not lost control of her character completely. She's not dead, but she does not currently have control of her character. And I am so excited to play again. This is also something, this whole exchange with the druid and the bad guy has been a long time coming. She got cursed by this guy way long ago. It was the third or fourth dungeon that I had the party do is where she got cursed. So it's, oops, I died. The laugh of the big bad evil guy just wants her body to go touring carnivals and really didn't want to rule the world. So that's what I have to figure out over the next week is what he seeks to accomplish with that. He has a physical form that he's not had for millennia. So I have to figure out what exactly he's going to do with that. And I love this part of Dungeons and Dragons. I love getting to write this stuff because I don't write a whole lot ahead of time. I have where major plot devices are and the state of them and how those get changed by what my players are doing. But I leave a lot undecided where there are possibilities of things so that as my players make decisions, the world can be shaped around them. If the druid hadn't used the magic item that she used to get in and communicate with this spirit in the first place, she wouldn't have had this option, and none of this would have ever even, I wouldn't have even bothered to think about any of this. Oh my god. So there's a lot of, there's a lot of stuff that I just don't write until things happen that would directly affect it. I leave a lot of it open-ended. The fish out of water gimmick, like a caveman in the future. So powerful by the standards of my time, but now the world is fucking scary. I'm not sure if I want to actually have her character there and interacting with the rest of the party. I think she's gonna leave early before the rest of the party's awake. So they're currently in a safe place in their own sort of safe house. So they're sleeping comfortably. There's no watches or anything. They're just around and nobody's keeping an eye on anybody. So I could very easily have her character slip out and just not be there for a few days, which is sort of what I'm thinking I want to do. And then what I will do for the next few days in game is have the party have no idea where her character is, and we will flash back and forth between the current party and her in her dream state communicating with someone else, maybe from the past that this ancient evil has absorbed somehow. Because one of his sources of power is a soul gem, quote unquote. So other lives could theoretically be there and able to be communicated with. So I might sort of allow her to peek into the soul gem where his power is sort of originated from and have her communicate with ghosts of people that he's killed or absorbed before, while the rest of the party deals with the druid missing and on a rampage, theoretically, possibly, doing whatever it is that might be happening. But I think I want it to be for a few days, and I don't know exactly. I'm gonna come up with something, because I'll only have a few days, so I can't get too crazy. The world is very big, and it takes a long time to travel, so he couldn't, like, use her body to go somewhere else and do a whole bunch in just a few days. But there is a lot of information that he could gather from where he is. I need to pay attention and actually kill these things. Real quick. Grab some fire bombs too. But yeah, needless to say, I am very excited to play D&D again. I need to practice my bad guy voice, though. I made this warlock, is what he's called, is the warlock. Even though he's not even a warlock, but they don't know that. He's actually a necromancer. I made his voice the same as Mum-Ra from Thundercats. But then I haven't watched Thundercats in a long time, and I haven't had to use his voice in a long time. So I'm sort of... I was a little out of practice, and it didn't sound like I wanted it to on Saturday. So I need to work on that. But yeah. There. The party is attempting to stop this thing from being awakened because they think another bad guy group is trying to control his power or awaken him just to eat the world or something. They're not sure what the actual reasoning is. They don't want them to get the keys to his tomb. And now they're making deals with him for power. So they're gonna pay the price. It was a fun session. It was a really fun session. Kill them all? He's got a gunpowder barrel. Ow. D&D is fun, guys. I love it so much. If I thought it would go well, if I had a better way of setting it up, I would absolutely contemplate trying to stream us playing, kind of like they do for Critical Role or something. Just because it's fun and would be hopefully somewhat interesting. Something that I enjoy a lot and would like to share, but I don't know that I have a way of setting that up well enough to make it worth it. Not to be a high enough of quality for people to enjoy watching. So for now, I'll just tell stories. But it is so much fun. My wife's character had a bit of a plague and had her hit point maximum reduced significantly. Unfortunately, she's the only one that got hit by it with this group of monsters that could do that to people. She's the only one that got hit, and she's a cleric, so she immediately healed it, and it was like an evening that her hit point maximum was lowered, and then she just got over it because she had greater restoration the next morning. So that was disappointing. But still fun. D&D's great. I do sort of miss playing as a player. I miss that a little bit. Being the dungeon master is great. I love it a lot. I wouldn't trade it. I would rather be the dungeon master than not play. But I sort of miss playing a character. It's been a while since I've been able to be a player character. Which is sort of why I was looking to play stuff like Divinity, so I can be a character and not have to worry about the Dungeon Master side. But we'll see. We'll see. Unfortunately, once you start DMing, everybody's like, "Oh, you're a dungeon master. You should run a game for us or something." You know, nobody's like, "Oh, you play D&D. We should get a group together and figure out who's going to DM." It's always, "So you're already a DM. You could do that, right?" So once you start, it's kind of like it's a little difficult, it seems to me at least, In my experience, it has been very difficult to go from DM back to player. But, you know, like I said, it's worth it still. Being the dungeon master is better than not playing at all. And that's what it really all comes down to. The boat coming this way. I could try to go start a alliance with him and help him fight the ghost ships. That could be cool. I could try that. What time is it? 11:40? I haven't been going that long. Yeah, I could probably do that. I could do that. I could pull that off. Maybe I could do good enough to actually contend in that fight. I will need to gather some materials. And I bet I could do that. I don't know if my in-game chat works. Because I'm using a new mic now, and I don't know that it works at all. Well, not a new mic for the stream, but eh. Surprised you're playing this solo? I just enjoy the game, honestly. And during the day, it's significantly less populated. Just like about any other game. So that guy's probably the only other person I'm ever gonna see today. Probably. But I just enjoy it. I understand that getting attacked by people is just part of the game, and, you know, if I lose stuff, I lose stuff. It can be absolutely disheartening, but it's still fun. I just like being a pirate. It is absolutely better with friends and way easier with friends, but I just have a good time. Is he coming this way? He sure is. If he attacks me, well, so be it. I guess I'll do my best to not die. You had to go and jinx me and say that you were surprised I was solo, and now this guy's like, oh, he's solo? Go get him. Oh, man, go get him. Don't say it so loud, man. Don't tell the whole server I'm solo. This goes to you. Sell. This goes to you. Nope, come on. I don't have anything worth it other than this chest now, anyway. So if he does come and attack... Oh, he's not even got sails. This guy's default sailing around. I could probably take him. I could take him. I'm over here with the Baron Bird, and he's over here default. I could take him. I could take him. I have put a lot of time into this game. I do know how to play it. For the most part. I don't think he's... Don't you do it. I see you next to that cannon. Don't you do it. There's two of them. They both look pretty default. Okay. I think we're okay. Nope. It's E. Where's Ahoy? I don't know if my in-game chat will work. Oh, those were the people that I saw on the Ferry of the Damned. Hup. All right, I don't think they're a problem. I'm not worried about them. I might try to offer some assistance if they are going back to fight Flameheart. I'll try to team up with them, maybe. See if we can take him out in an alliance. But I am solo slooping, which would make this a little more difficult. combat like that, at least, would be a little more difficult. I'm willing to give it a shot. Hup. Oh, I didn't get any more cannonballs. I don't have many... I don't have a lot of stuff. I would not be able to last long in a fight. Maybe that's a bad idea. I would have to not get hit much and make every shot count. And Flameheart's a long fight. And they're here to loot the island too, which is going to make it less... There should be less stuff. Maybe. We'll see what I can get before I leave. There's no barrels up here. We'll see what I can get before I leave. I could just go on their ship. I'll just go with them to fight Flameheart, leave mine here. Load everything off of my ship onto theirs and just see what we can do. I don't have any treasure to share with them either. There would be at all of that stuff. And Flameheart's ships will drop the ghost stuff. And I'm in a sloop. I could probably... Maybe I could handle that. I don't have a lot of... Let me fish a little bit. Keep an eye on them, sort of. I'll listen for them. I'm gonna fish a little bit. Because if I can get some fish and cook those, then... Having cooked food will be... Might just be what I need to have the upper hand. Come on, you little gremlin. Whatever event's happening right now has to do with fishing as well. That's something that doesn't happen anymore. Nobody makes any good fishing games anymore. I really enjoy fishing in video games. Even in like Minecraft, I enjoy fishing. It's just a good time. Maybe I should try to find a fishing game to play on stream. Just for one, just like for a day. Oh, come on, you're like right here. Got him. Watch them turn around, they're gonna be standing here with like a gunpowder barrel. Okay. I was waiting to just turn around and just be greeted with both of them on my ship, gunpowder barrel in either hand. And they just light it and bounce. What I was afraid of. He's under the dock. All right, let's see. Let's see what they say. I don't know if my in-game chat works, or I would. Sailed in the wrong part of town, boy. Hi. Well, I believe that answers what I'll be doing then. Come, fish. Fish. The moment we are smashed. Oh, I see. They've been drinking in the tavern. All right, well, let's go for it then. Let me raise the Alliance flag. Here we go. If you're willing If you're willing to raise the Alliance flag and I'll join ye. See how this works. See how this goes. We should be close enough. So I've got not a lot of stuff, but... They should add ironclad warships. I don't know if, I don't know if that would really fit the theming. While I agree with you, I don't know that that would really fit the theme too well. Scraping just a bit. No, we're okay. Turn around here and scoot a bit closer. Because there it is. He just dove back off. Man, if I could get, like, battleships... Just big ol' frickin'... That'd be pretty dope. I'm not gonna lie. That would be pretty dope. It would be impossible to balance, but... It would be dope. Join Alliance. Boom! The Resolute Scallywags! That's it. Now, can I go back to this? Does it take me out of the Alliance? Leave Alliance. Can I put Banjo back on? Am I still in the Alliance? Yeah! Oh, and it's blue and yellow Oh, sweet. It even fits. Yes! Let's rock and roll. Ironclads were around since the 1800s. Okay. I mean, yeah, timeline-wise, in real life, I suppose it does. She turns so I don't ram them. Catch a little bit of wind and swing it back around. Oh, I should actually try to grab some of these barrels. Other side. Pop. Oh, that one's empty! God dang it. Alright, straighten her out. God, this is what I love about this game, is this kind of stuff. I'm not even after the loot. I just want to do this in an alliance. I mean, I don't even want the stuff for it. They may attack me. I mean, they're pretty standard looking. They look like they've not been at this too long. Platy Pants, what are you doing? Why are you posting links that you know Moobot's gonna get mad at? What was that? Was that not YouTube or something? I can... Not that. Let me... Permit. Picture of an ironclad ship? Oh, yeah, well. Showing off warships. That one I can't do much about. I can't leave. I cannot allow Google just to be linked in chat because that is asking for trouble. Unfortunately. And the permit thing vanishes and it disappears and goes away. Wikipedia? Oh, I guess that's a little bit safer. I don't know how many whitelists I have either. How do I friggin'... I don't know how to permit... I think it's down below. I don't know. The I'll get to it in a second. I'm about to have combat. Sorry. Hold on. Hey! Race along a ship! Heck yeah, I didn't have that achievement. Oh, heck yeah. I got real world money. Let's take them out, laddies! I don't know if that came through or not, but let's go for it. I should get cannonballs. I don't have much. Don't have much. I gotta get away from them so that I can shoot other things. Yeah, you guys go for it. Alright, here we go, boys. Oh, he's got different dialogue. Ooh, that's cool. Yeah, you better believe it. We're the swashbuckling scallywags, or whatever it said. Okay, this one I've got up here. I am on my own. A little high. Oh, no, that was a perfect hit. Ooh! I don't want to hit them. Oh, they got it. They got it. Yeah. Oh, excellent. Let's go. Let's go. Here we go. Oh, watch it, boys. Careful, boys. Got it. Oh, this is perfect. This is going so well. They added an ironclad ship as a... Oh, okay, now that would be dope. One of these skeleton lords in an ironclad, that would be cool. That would be really cool. All right, let's make sure we don't ram this skeleton ship or ghost ship. Got some behind us as well. I'm gonna try to slow down just a bit. Oh, barrels. No, get the harpoon. Twing. Ah, missed. All right, get off the harpoon. Get off the cannon. Load. Oh, it wasn't loaded. I'm the fuel. Oh, I missed that one. This is the problem with being alone, is everything is so much harder. Alright, if they're gonna circle here... No, actually, I'm gonna circle here. I wanna hit this guy. Bring this around to this side. Ooh. One man army, I'm going for it, at least. Load. And light him up! Couple of hits. Bring her around. Actually, you know what? Just keep bringing her around. I can hit him again. I'll just finish this guy off. Boom! Oh, I miss. I missed. Okay, alright. He's dropping mines. I can hear it. That one is. They went out in the middle of it. That's dangerous. Woohoo, there they are. Too much? Ooh. This game have those chain? Yes, they do. There are chain shots, yes. Oh, things are bad. I don't have an angle on this guy. Yeah, I've got some in my inventory, actually. Okay, we're good. All good. Whoosh. Am I out of cannonballs? I'm out of cannonballs on me. Well, I don't have many. Right into the middle of them. Keep her going, boys. There's one down. Woohoo! I don't like that very much. Woohoo, hi! Oh, a good thing I'm maneuverable. Oh, hello. You're not supposed to be that close to me. Sure does. I don't have the gear for this. There's no way this is gonna go well. Let's see something stupid like a 10-man sloop. Oh my god. You could probably finagle that. If you could get... You could get 10 people... Yeah, everyone abandon ship and jump on a one sloop. That would have to be how it goes. That would be very fun, though. I am in full agreement. That would be very fun. Ooh, that was it. Get dunked on, scrub. Get good. Come at me, scrub. I'm ripped. It's too short by a lot. He's farther away than I thought he was. My forces increasing. Oh, that didn't hit either? Oh, come on. Nah, they're too short. Oh, I'm on fire. I'm out of cannonballs. I need to stop wasting shots. My water bucket's empty! Ow! Okay, well, there's about to be some water down there. Oh, I don't have any wood on me. Whew. What do we do with the drunken... Oh, my God. What do we do with a drunken doctor? What do we do with a drunken doctor? Don't shoot me, 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 don't shoot me. Just let me sneak on past. Oh, you shot me! Wood. Whew. Like pirate ship battles, you'll love Assassin. I loved Black Flag. It was so good. Not an incredible assassin game, but a wonderful pirate game. Absolutely. I still sing some of those some of those sea shanties just in my average everyday life. In fact, I'm lots of water. I intend to there's so much water. I don't really need to worry about that right now. That one's a small one and it's at the front. I'm okay. I just want to not get... Ugh! Oh no! Oh no, we're okay. We're okay. That was all top deck. Woo! Hi! Did I get rid of all the water? Okay, there we go. There we go. Leave that there. Okay, I'm back. I need to get back on the outside and just pick them off from the outside. But yes, Black Flag was wonderful. I loved it. Oh, my wheel's damaged. I intend to teach the kids on my bus sea shanties. My boss said I can't do any of the ones about drinking, so that really narrows it down. That vastly limits me, but... I have some that I'm going to try to teach them because they like to sing stupid kids songs, right? They sing like Baby Shark and like bad, like stupid stuff that's mind-numbingly obnoxious. So the next time that they start singing, I'm going to be like, hey, how about this? How about this? You guys repeat after me and then we'll do a piratey song. I hear water guzzling. Oh, I left that one in the front. That's okay. I'm actually okay on wood. Oh, they must have took one out. Oh, phase change. Phase change. The boys are doing work over there. I'm trying my bestest. Load both of these. All sea shanties are either about drinking or sex. Most of them. Yes, most of them. I still hear water guzzling. What's happening? That was only the beginning here. All right. I'll have a good angle, though. I'm going to take some hits, but I'll have a good angle. Here we go. So this is the first boss phase. All right, Kazooie. Hold on tight. It's about to get crazy. Slow it down. I love the music in this game. God dang. Here we go. Dead on. Also a hit. Nailed him. Eat that. Suck a big one. Give me them toes. We're good, we're good, we're good. We're fine. Whew. Yeah, we're fine, we're fine, we're fine. This is good. As long as I'm not about to hit those rocks over there. We're okay. Whew. Someone knows the good old Sea Dogs. I remember Sea Dogs. I don't know that I played it all that much, but I remember it. Maybe my dad had it? Maybe. Are they on that one? Okay. Ah, they're a little out of range. Ooh, I'm running low. I'm running low. Oh, I don't know what you could do with his toes. No. No, you don't. Do a black flag. I could play black flag again. That one's all right. Whoops, wrong button. Nailed him. The glancing blow. Also a hit. Get out of my way. Get out of my way. Get, oh, I got that one. Oh, there's so many holes back there. Oh, God. So many holes back here. No, 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 no. Oh, God. Assassin's Creed Rogue? I don't know what that one is. Island! Island! Uh-oh. Ow. I'm on fire. Let me just step into here. Whoops, I had water in that. Uh-oh. Gotta put this out. I don't know what Rogue is. I've not seen Assassin's Creed Rogue. Oh, I missed. Ooh. Essentially just Black Flag, but as a Templar? That could be fun, because I've not played that one. I'm amazed I've survived this long, too, to be perfectly honest. Flameheart. Turn back, turn back, turn back. I don't want to be back in the rocks. Okay, let's speed. I am speed. Let's put this fire out for real. Oh, God, it's spreading. Oh, God, it's still spreading. I'm out of water. Oh, they're still shooting at me. I missed! How much longer can you last? I don't know, probably not long enough, though. Load. Hail Mary. Come on, come on. Did I hit something? I heard the bit of the trumpet. I might have hit him. All right, stop that. Whew, whew. Rogue just has naval warfare and it's not really a pirate game. Black Flag. Oh, the Black, I haven't played any of the DLC. Things are getting bad up here. I've got to put this out. It'd be great if it started raining or something. Ah! Sorry, dudes. Sorry. Oh, my God. There's a friggin' megalodon. Oh, my God. Okay, we're all good. We're all good. What are we on? What am I running aground on? Is that them still? That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. Whew, boy. All right. This has gone far enough. I'm not waving off yet. I'm not leaving this fight like this. Playing with random dudes. Yep, these are just random people that showed up. I'm not waving off. I'm gonna keep up. I've still got cannonballs. I've still got wood. I can survive a bit longer. There's a hole up here somewhere, I think. Yeah, there's a random group that were up here trying to fight Flameheart that came over to the place where I was, and I was like, hey guys, if you're gonna fight this guy, let's do an alliance and let's go. And they were like, yeah, sure. Usually there's no friendship. Oh, believe me, I know. I have experienced the lack of friendship in this game many a time. I'm a bit of a unique case. Me and my crew are usually quite agreeable. We very rarely shoot first. So when those guys came floating up, especially with them being just default ships, I was like, I could probably take these guys. Let's just see what they're up to. So now we're fighting Flameheart. Well, that was thunder. It's the garbage trucks. It's so much more fun making friends with people. Like, and I don't mean to sound like a like a hippie, but it really, like, this game is much more fun when you're not just jumping people, you know? I might be a bit of a hippie, but let's not ignore the balls. I needed one of those. It is much more fun when you form random alliances like this. Now, Reapers, if you're flying a Reaper's flag, I'm on you. I will sink you for the fun of it. I will punch you for fun if you fly a Reaper's flag. That's just asking for PvP. And usually Reapers are kind of dicks. Oh, it's the other side. Usually. Not always. The Reaper's flag is one of the factions. They're sort of a survival of the fittest type guild and encourage stealing loot. Like, Reapers get more reward for stealing treasure and selling it than they do discovering treasure and stealing it, if that makes sense. So their goal is to take the loot that other people have already stolen, already found. Dang. So you can get flags for each of the factions and gain more money for dealing with them directly. And the Reapers are the ones that encourage stealing from other people and sinking other ships and stuff. So those guys, I'm just like, nah, if you've got a Reaper's flag, I'm just gonna attack you. Sorry. Got it. Yes. No, it's wood! I mean, that's good, but balls! I need cannonballs. Faaah! Oh, we got six. Yeah, I'm low. And they're staying out of my range. All right, I'm gonna loop back around and try to get these other guys. It's just the PvP. Yes, it is. It's the PvP guild. Because you've got gold hoarders that are all about going and discovering treasure, finding X's on maps, that sort of stuff. The Order of Souls are all about bounties and killing skeletons and returning the undead to being dead. And then the Sea Dogs are the actual PvP, but they're for sport, not for... They're PvP for glory, not for gold. And then there's Hunter's Call, which are fishermen. The whalers. Go down! Ooh, I got that one. I got one. All right, we're good. Ooh, we're not good. Oh, we're less good. I've got the wood. That's not the problem. It's just the cannonballs that are really the problem. All right, we're fine. We're fine. We're fine. I'm solo slooping it now. The others went off to refuel and rearm. Hopefully they'll be back. Okay, it's a small hole. I can adjust. Swing her around. Can I catch something here? Can I catch something here? Cannonballs would be greatly appreciated. Wood! Fuck it anyway. All right. We got this. We've got just a handful left that I've got to make the most of. I think what I have on me is what's left. Okay. All right, we good? We good? A little bit of water down here is not a problem. It keeps the fires out. Straight on, straight on, straight on. I'll take some hits from passing through that one, but I can nail the flagship. I'm out! I'm out! There's nothing left! They're all gone! Ooh, ooh! Ah! That's okay. Balls, I'm gonna have to lose this. There was wood in that, but it's okay. I need this. I need that. Give me that. No! Give me that. Yes! We're good. We're golden. We're fine. What's... Oh, God! Oh, God! Okay. We're fine. We're fine. We're fine. This is okay. This is okay. All right. We're good. We're good. It's all good. It's all good. They're still screaming around. Wood. Take that. Ooh. Prepare. Okay. I hope those guys, I hope they come back. I hope they make it back in time. I'm not backing out. Come on. Pick up. Yep, I'll take it because I can move the whole thing. Cannonballs. Hell yeah. Where are you at, ghost ships? Let's go. It's all kicking off now, boyos. I gotta get rid of one of these flagships to get the next phase. And hopefully they can make it back. Whew. The chain shots, they take, the only problem with them, I do have them, they don't work for the masts on the ghost ships because they're not physical. You can't tear the masts down. It's literally just I have to do this and click them to equip them is the only reason that I don't use them as often, because I forget about them in the heat of the moment. I forget to use them. I can still get hits on them, and I think it'll do two small holes, but I can't take the masts down on the... Oh, is it the black and red one? Dang. The masts aren't... Yeah, it's like... It's weird. Yeah, the hull is physical enough that you can shoot it, but... Ow. But you can't actually tear the masts down. Here we go. I want the middle one. Pop. Loading chain shot. Pop. Oh, I sunk it. Yes. Oh, I'm enjoying it. Bring this up. I want that loot, because that one should have dropped loot. All right. What did we take? What kind of hits did we take? This one. There we go. Whew. With other ships, you can absolutely hit their mast with chain shot, and it just makes it fall. It's really cool. I thought I heard more water, but maybe not. Why am I not turning? Yeah, a little bit, but I'm keeping at it. Oh, I have to take out both flagships? Balls. All right. All right. Bring her around. Headed for those ghosts right there. Because that should be treasure and potentially supplies. I'm going to take it slow so that I've got time to unload this barrel a little bit. I want to keep it like PG-13. I'm only allowed one, and I don't want to... I'm only allowed one F-bomb. At least that's the joke that we've used in Halo. We're allowed one F-bomb, and I don't want to waste it here. And there's, you know, save it for when it's useful, you know? Just in general. I don't need... Oh, boy. All right. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, God. Cut it back this way. Oh, I'm not going fast enough. I'm going to die. They're going to take me out. But I need to hit this one. Okay, those were hits. That's what matters. You're a pirate. You gotta swear like a sailor. I guess, man. I don't know. I guess if I do it in a pirate voice, it doesn't count, right? Get me over there. I gotta bring these back up. Ah, the Megalodon's still here. Bring it around. Slow it down. Do not jump me. Whew, the Megalodon scares me. I'm concerned about that. Man, I hope my crew comes back. That would be the most appreciative thing. Give me something. It's just out of range. Give me something. There's so many things there. God dang it. I'll drop an anchor. And just hope the Megalodon doesn't attack me. Ah. Crate. Yes. That's what I needed. That's supplies. Ooh, quit running away. This stuff looks so cool. I love the aesthetic of this ghost stuff. Come on. Get it. Okay, I think the Megalodon is gone. He's not going to attack me from here. And if I wait long enough, theoretically, the other ghost ships will teleport to me. Storage crate? Nope, ashes. Okay. Bring this wheel around this way. That's missing. Don't have any handles. Oh, I have one. The other one's still there. Whew. All right. My neck's getting stiff. I'm tensing up. Where did my crew go? I had an alliance here. Where are they at? They teleported. Where's the... There they are. Oh, perfect. Perfect. Let's put them down. Restock. Load. Yes, he's down. All right, one more set of all of that, so I really need them to come back because there's about to be a lot more ships. Am I missing a peg? Are we all good here? Nope, we're all good. Whew. We're fine. There's gonna be a lot more ghost ships spawning. Okay, that should be them in the distance there. Hopefully they will make their way back. Because we're in phase two or three. Yeah, regular ghost ships. I just need to grab whatever that is. Got a little bit of sail. I'm just drifting a little bit. I need whatever this stuff is before something gets over here to try to kill me. Oh, it's a lot. Okay. Whew. Oh, I'm too far away. It takes just minor adjustments take so much time. All right, bring this up. Come on, boyos, get back over here. Get back in the fight. Restock and get back. Yeah, honestly, me too. On my own. I'm just as amazed, to be perfectly honest. Oh. I'm not used to having to do all this either, because my wife is really good as a carpenter. She's great with... She knows exactly how to prioritize damage and can tell exactly... She's practiced so much that she just knows exactly which ones to fix first and which ones not to, which ones can wait. She's wonderful at this, and I've only done a little bit of that. I'm usually the helmsman. I'm the captain, so having to do all of it is a little overwhelming at times. Oh, I'm gonna get jumped, and there is gonna be able to hit me. I need this off of there. Oh, I'm still rotating a little bit. That's gonna hit. It's all superficial. Nope, it missed. Ah. Oh, no. Okay. That one could have sucked. Not tab. Bucket. Nope, there's no water. There's no water. Is there any in there? Nope, no water at all. Making a stack of chests. Yep. Eventually, I'll get to sell all of those, unless I sink. Yeah, now I don't want to sink. Now I want to survive this. Oh, balls. Oh, balls. Son of a bitch. That's not good. Remember what I said about sinking? Yeah, that's happening. That's probably in the process of happening. Jeez, I gotta get out. I just gotta get clear. Okay. That's bad. That's bad. That's bad. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay. Oh, this is bad. I gotta get clear. Please, just get out of here. Just go. Just go, boat. Just stay afloat for just long enough to get away from these things so that I can take inventory and survive. Straighten out. Straighten out. Right here. Oh, no. Not right there. Turn a little bit. There we go. Okay. That should get me clear. Oh, God. Oh, God. I really need those dudes to come back and take some of the heat off of me. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Almost every possible spot that could have a hole has a hole. I think that's a small one. This is not the one that I should have been fixing. Maybe it was a big one. That took a second. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay. No, we're okay. We're good. We're good. We're fine. We're fine. We're fine. All right. I'm mostly clear. I want to raise the sails so that I'm not just hightailing it out. Just a good bit. And move a little bit. Bucket. Whew. Oh, I really need those dudes to come back. Oh, my God. I can't keep up with it. Oh, they're all just pouring. They're all just pouring in. Okay, I'm okay. I got it. Did I already bucket? Yes. Why aren't those dudes coming back? I should have known I'd have to do this on my own. Okay, okay. It's okay. Turn. I'm drifting too far back into range there. Uh-oh. Yep. That's what I was afraid of. These up front. It's just pouring. Bucket. Throw it! Get out! Throw it! Ooh! Ooh! That one didn't make it out. That's why that happened. We're good. We're good. We're fine. Golden. I'm out of wood. Okay. Just a little bit, just little by little. I just have to take it piece by piece. This one. Bucket sure can hold a fuck. Yeah, it can. It's a lot. It's way. Ooh. Did I hit something? No. Okay, I am sort of drifting towards this island, though. I need to turn back. There is a lot of water that it can hold. Yes, it's wonderful. Whew, okay. I'm sort of getting ahead of it now. Oh God, okay. I can cool down a little bit. I can relax just a little. I'm okay with some water being in here because if they hit me with fire, then that puts the fire out automatically. Oh, I need those guys to come back. Pennsylvania's calling. Not now. I can't do my bit right now. There's... Oh, I threw water back at my boat. All right, here we go. Hello, thank you for calling Dr. Payne 64. I'm live on Twitch right now. Come on in, drop a follow. I'm playing Sea of Thieves. Man, this is crazy. I'm fighting Captain Flameheart. It's going nuts. Get in here, follow, subscribe. It's $5. You get a whole bunch of emotes. We got the best redeemable thing on Twitch. You can make a nut button. They hung up. Oh boy. Excellent. All right, let's get back in this. Back to war, boyos. Eat some fish. Nah, we're doing pretty good now, man. This is wonderful now. All the holes are repaired. No water down here. Let's get to it. Let's fight. Let's go. I'm alive. I'm a man. Whew. I've got to be the best pirate I've ever seen. Cue Gangplank Galleon. Let's go. Whew. All right, Flameheart. Big old floating head in the sky. I fought floating heads before. I played Star Fox. Let's go. What you got? You ain't got nothing on me. I fought floating heads that had hands and incredibly advanced technology before. You ain't nothing I ain't killed before. Well, let's go. Let's go. Yeah. Woo. I don't think those guys are coming back. Yeah, they may not be. I might be on my own. Because they're that way. They were at that. Oh no, there they are. That's them. That's them. They are over there. Load cannonball. It's close. This one's crossing. Pop. It would be great if they did, just to take some of the heat. That one hit. That one hit, and that one should hit. Down. Ship down! Alright, what are you lads doing? Let's go. Come on. Get over here. Help me fight. I'm still in this. Whew. This is exciting. I'm having a blast. I hope this is enjoyable to watch, because I'm having a blast. Shoot at this guy. Well, no, I should shoot at this guy. Left the Alliance? They left the Alliance! They left the Alliance! Cowards! You cowards! Cowards! Oh my god, I can't believe it. I've been abandoned.
I'm not done yet.
Can't believe it. I've put a lot of hours in this game. I'm good at staying alive, at the very least. I'm not great at the game in general, but I can stay alive. It's all superficial. It's back here. Whew. I can't believe they left. That's so upsetting. That's more upsetting than what's happening in this combat right now. This is one of those. Yes, if I go down, if my ship sinks, everything in my barrels is gone. All of this loot is left floating in the water, and I completely fresh respawn. It wouldn't be the worst thing in the world if I was to go down, but it would be a little disheartening. It'd be sort of depressing. Not so much that I would hate myself, but it would sort of suck. Back to basic. Yep. I think it would keep my Banjo-Kazooie stuff on the ship that it reloads, but it would be basic kit. I would have 8 bananas and 10 cannonballs, and that's it. I've got some I can waste now, actually. Need to get closer, though. Still taking on water anywhere? I think we're okay. There's some down here, but I don't see any more leaking. Yeah, I think I'm good. I can't believe they disbanded. They left the Alliance. What? Cowards! Oh, it's so upsetting. They have no honor as pirates. Weaklings. If you couple of people, whoever you were, ever see this, I want you to know that I'm disappointed in you and that you're cowards. They may have left the game is the problem. If they're still over there when I get done with this, ooh, they're going to get it. I'm sinking them. The only thing worse than a Reaper The only thing worse than someone that would attack someone for without provocation just for the gold is a coward. Oh, I hit him. Oh, I killed him. Oh, I'm the best shot in the West.
This has gone far enough.
You, you're next. Get some. I'm the best pirate you've ever seen. Oh, there's supplies over there too. Sorry, I don't know what that voice was. I don't know where that came from. Came from a dark place. I apologize. Hop. Hop. They're closer than I thought they were. More that'll do it.
A direct hit.
God, they didn't go down. Ah, they didn't go down. Are we good? Is there fire? No, we're good. We're good. We're golden. Oh. All right, let's go. Let's go. You want some? You want some? Get over here and fight me, ghosts. You. Hey, you're in range. Sorta, kinda. You're a bit far out, but you're in range. I led that a little too much. I've got plenty of cannonballs now, I can waste them. Wow, I'm not hitting that guy at all. I got loads in here, though. I'm amazed, too. Kinda. I don't want to go in too far. I don't want to get surrounded, because if they're on both sides of me, then I'm the one that's going to get the short end of that stick. Ooh! No, that'll miss. That's going to miss. This was a good pirate voice thing. I don't know if I read that already or not. One more hit. Ah. We're good. You're right, it's not. I'm kicking your ass. Your bony pirate lord ass.
Come forth and fight for me.
He's getting scared. One. Two. Uh-oh. Okay, that was just fire. That's okay. That's manageable. Bucket. Uh-oh, I had water. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, this is bad. I need to get out of the middle of this. All right. Oh, no. Get down. Put that out. Bucket. Okay, we're good. It's fine. Just to trust that I'm not dying up there. Ooh, I saw the lights off of... That didn't sound good. Oh, no. Okay. It's fine. These are little holes. It's fine. Little holes don't leak as bad as the big ones. All good? Mast is still up? Wheel still put together? Still have sails? As long as we have our sails in the air and wind at our backs, we're still fighting, lads. I'm leaving some water down in there still. Keep the fires out. Whew. I'm gonna need a grog after this one, boys. That guy. He's next. That's not what I wanted to do. Don't know if that one's damaged or not, but probably not. Alright, I just gotta keep picking off the ones on the outside. Aren't they pointed this way? Am I missing a... No, that's all good. And, well, I'm missing a peg on the capstan, but that's okay. Oh, no, they're pointing the other way. Balls. Ah, that's the only hard part about this, is if you stay on the outside, you've got to be with the wind to get to anybody, because... They don't need wind to sail. What a shot. What a shot. That was so close. That was so close. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. Cut it. Bring this to the front, because that's where I'm gonna be facing. I'm looping back around on him. Let's go, boys! Got good wind. There we go. That's what we wanted. Right here. Whoops. Probably a good bit. Down.
The odds are still in my favor.
Yeah, probably, but I've never been one for odds. This one right here. No, that's too high. They're too far out. That's a hit. That was a hit. Oh, that last one's not gonna get, so they've got two hits in them. That one's about down. Dang, how many of these am I gonna have to sink? I didn't want to do this on my own, that's why I wanted the Alliance. Ugh. I might have to bail without this fight being over. I don't know that I can win this in a timely manner. It's almost 1 o'clock. I might have to bail on time. Dang, yeah, they're gone. Cowards! Still, I'm gonna be salty about that all day. I'm gonna be mad about this, that other ship leaving all day. That's gonna hit me. Oh, I missed. Oh, I'm out of cannonballs. Shoot! Shoot! Well. I got some hits on it. And they didn't hit me at all, I don't think. Ugh. Dang, I would like a victory here, but... I'm afraid I might have to just leave after I get another... If I can get one more set of stuff, then I'll take it, but... I might just have to bail. It's still a victory. I wouldn't have lost. It just wouldn't have been... Alright, I guess it wouldn't necessarily be a victory. I wouldn't have lost, but I wouldn't have really won either. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, it missed. Oh... If that one hits, it's down. Yes!
I need to change my tactics.
Oh! Oh, that's the end of the phase! Oh, that's the boss, this final boss! Good bit longer, actually. We're okay. That's it, all those went away. Okay, I got two sets of stuff that I should try to grab. Cause I'm gonna need more gear, because this is gonna take a lot. Okay, boss phase. Final boss phase. Oh boy, three sets of them. Oh god, why couldn't this be any easier because I'm alone? He's got four escorts. I just have to kill the flagship, and that ends it. The burning blade. Oh no! Repair that. I need to be back on the harpoon to grab the one that's in the water. Oh no, did I pass it already? Oh no, there it is. Okay. Should be just a storage crate. It's out of range. No, it's not. I can hit it. Ah, balls. Yeah, this isn't good. I might need to bail. Oh, I wanna beat it so bad. I wanna beat it so bad. Ah! 15 minutes, and then I have to leave. Not leave, but I'll have to bail. I have 15 minutes. I hear more fire? Oh, it's still burning there. Okay. All right, here we go. Let's do this. Wooden planks, cannonballs.
It's time to end this.
All right, just because I'm noticing that it's quieter, I need to bring music up just a tad. It's supposed to be louder than that, because this music's really good. Barrels. Under the birds. Ah, nope. I was past them already. God, there's so many of them. I just need to kill one of them, I think. I just need to kill one of the flagships. That's all. Okay. They're coming this direction. Wind. Nope, this way. Those are teleporting? Are there three sets of the flagships? Okay, turn this way then. Too much. I'm missing some of my shots now. Because I don't want to hit the island. Oh, that's not the burning blade. That's not the right ship. I have to get the one with the black sails. Oh no! Oh no. That was the big one. Ah! That was the Wraith. I'm going to have to bail. I don't think I can do this. Not alone. Maybe with enough time. I'm going to get hit again before I get out of this. Dang it. Shoot. I just want to get out alive. Oh no! 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 They knocked me overboard! No! Mermaid! I need... Oh no! No! I was just gonna make a beeline right there! Give me the mermaid! I might be able to save it! Oh no! Come on, get me back! Take me back to my ship, please! Get me back! Oh god, oh no! No! My ship sunk! Ah! Oh! It put me on an island! That means my ship's gone. Oh. Oh no. That was so much money that could have put me at a million. Oh. Oh, the pain. Oh my god. I was on my way out too. I had made the decision to leave. Oh, it hurts. Oh, it hurts. We fought well, lads. We gave it our best.
It's time.
I'm in the water still! Just take me back to somewhere, please! Please, just take me back to somewhere.
Oh, we gave it our best, lads. If that other ship had stayed, we would have won that. Oh, God, I hope nobody's in the apartment upstairs. Oh, we're at Galleon's grave, too. We're where we started. We're where we formed that alliance. Dang. Oh, that hurts. Well, pour one out, boys. For the loot that we had and the love that we lost. It's been fun. That was good. Let's play a sad song. I'm drunk. Sounds so bad. Does anyone have enough points to redeem a sing the outro? Does anyone have that right now? Does anyone currently have that? Or... Oops, sorry. Well, I might just do it anyway. It's fine. We'll do it. How well does the sea shanty come through? Let me turn that up a little bit. I'm gonna sing us a pirate song. Because I just like the pirate songs. Can I turn that up? I can just turn the game up a little bit. I just want good levels. You guys are getting a free sing the outro. Okay, yeah, that sounds okay. Because that's the only good way to end... To end Sea of Thieves is with a sea shanty. And I'm gonna... This one in this game is from this game. I believe the staff at Rare wrote a song. God, alright. I hope the music sounds good enough to you guys. Is it like at a good level? Can you hear it? Is it good? Can you hear that accurately enough? Well enough? I wish I had backup, because this one is really good on the concertina and the frickin' hurdy-gurdy. Our ship, she dreams of wind in her sails, of wind in her sails unfurled. And shining as we cross the sea, we cross the sea for home. And we'll all raise our voices, a song in our hearts, and set our eyes. shores with wind in our sails again. They'll be cheering and calling. No more squabbling and brawling. When we have the wind in our sails, when we have our feet on the ground, we'll sow our good fortune around. There'll be peace and good pleasure. No more rationing and measure. When we have the wind in our sails. Thank you very much, guys. I appreciate it. I try. I want to take some voice lessons. I think that'd be cool. But I just particularly like sea shanties, and that song in particular. So thank you for being here. Thanks for joining me on this. Now you gotta blow the ship up. I would, but I lost everything. That's usually how... Yeah, it already got blown up. I will admit, that is usually how this ends, is we will blow the ship up, burn it down, and stand on it and play music while it sinks. Unfortunately, I don't have the stuff for that now because I just sank. So, thank you for being here. We'll be back tomorrow with something else. And don't forget to thank your bus driver. You guys have a wonderful day. And I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye. How'd you get the cool diamonds on the back, though? It reset you to... Wait, what? Oh, the cannons. Yeah, this stuff stays, because these are just... I don't have to pay for these. I bought these. This is my stuff. This is the Banjo-Kazooie stuff. This stuff stays. Sorry. I was literally about to click the stuff. But yeah, your designs, all that stuff stays. It's just you lose all your gear. So, like, all this stuff's gone. Well, except for, like, the basic stuff. You got basics. All the rest of it's gone. I'm back down to 8 stuff. 15 wood. It's all gone. This stuff is all just cosmetic. It doesn't do anything for you. Yeah, that's why that stuff stays. But anyway, see you guys later. Maybe we'll play some more of this. Because I'll always play Sea of Thieves. If I was close enough, yes. Theoretically. It's kind of like Minecraft, where eventually it'll despawn and go away, but it's like five or ten minutes that it will float there in the water. But there's all still ghost ships, and I don't have the gear to really like. If I was to get attacked too much, it'd be rough because all that's going to be sitting wherever my boat sank. So it's probably still in the middle of combat that I would have to get to it. So it's too much. More trouble than it's worth. And I already sang my sea shanty, so we're leaving. Theoretically, yes, you could go recover your loot. Theoretically. It doesn't always work out that way, but theoretically, yes, you can. So, you guys have a wonderful day. I need to go eat some lunch. I'm a little lightheaded from screaming at getting knocked off the boat. Have a wonderful day. We'll be back tomorrow. We're going to find some time to play some Mario Kart this week, I think. Absolutely. And then hopefully we'll find some time to do Star Wars Battlefront. You guys have a wonderful day. And farewell.